nation can't be with you today, so I'm going to do assembly instead. Hooray! My name is Happy Ted, and I'm going to lead assembly. I'd like to introduce a special guest. The well-done penguin's going to come and help us out as well. Here he is now. Hello. So, off we go. Today is Thursday, the 11th of February. Welcome to all the children at home. Hello. And welcome to all the children at school.
Hello.
Let's begin today's assembly with birthday news. Today's special guest presenter for birthday news is Mrs. Sharp. There she is, hard at work. Let's interrupt her and ask her if she'll do the birthday names. Let's go. Here we go. Press the bell. Come on. That's it. Well done. Well done, me. I did the bell there. Hello, Mrs. Sharp. Nice to see you. Are you okay to do birthday news?
Of course.
Excellent. Don't forget, you need to put the hat on.
Thank you very much. We've got lots of birthdays to talk about today, starting with Ella in year one. We also have Thomas in year six, William in reception, Evie in year six, Ronnie in reception, Isabel in year three, Samuel in year four, and Logan in year two. Have a very happy birthday, and we look forward to seeing you all back at school soon.
Hang on, Mrs. Sharp, aren't there some other people you might have forgotten?
Of course. A very, very special happy birthday to Mrs. Wood and to Mr. Pryor. Have a very happy birthday.
Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you.
Hello. As you know, I am the well done penguin. Where's my feet? Here's my feet. Oh. Oh yes, the well done penguin. I am really missing you all, and I am missing our Friday assemblies. I used to come to everyone to see who was going to be a star learner. So it gives me great pleasure to introduce this week's star learners. Here they are.
Thank you, well done penguin. It's great to see you again. This week's star learners are Sophia in year six, well done Sophia. Jack for year five, nice one Jack. Year four, Izzy, well done. Coco, year three, congratulations Coco. Lysander in year two. Ellis in year one. And Gracie, this week's reception star learner. As always, your certificates will make their way over to you by Schoolping later today.
That was brilliant. Well done all the star learners. It was great to see you all doing so well at home and at school.
It's good news board time. I'm back with more good news to share. Hooray! First up, and I think we might start a trend here, we have Danny and Layton with the newest addition to their family. They've got a new puppy called Arlo. And I hear, Danny, that Arlo, having Arlo in your life makes you feel happy. I can understand why. You mentioned that you were hoping to get a new puppy, and I'm pleased to see that that day has finally arrived. Fantastic. Thank you for sharing. Welcome, Arlo. I hope Arlo's being good. And it's a great reason to have your daily walks, isn't it, Danny and Layton? Cats, no good for that. Next up, I've had some more items from your teachers to share. Love this. So first up, Mr. Price has sent me something from Samuel. Samuel, you got stuck into your topic work, didn't you, last week, I think. And you made a stop motion animation of, let's have a look. Let's have a look first.
This is a blue marlin preying on a school of sardines. Blue marlin usually hunt in packs of six or seven like wolves. A blue marlin's tactic is to swim through the school, encouraging the sardines to the surface. But if the school dive deeper, the marlin encourages them back up. They catch the fish on their nose.
Wow. So tell me, Samuel, did you actually make that video? Is that your own stop motion? That's impressive. And I particularly like the research that you did beforehand, the blue marlins and how they catch their sardines. So you've done the legwork there, haven't you? Taught me something. Interesting. Well done. Next, we have Molly in year four. Miss Maitland sent me your 5 o'clock news with Molly. Let's have a look at yours.
Hello everyone, welcome back to 5pm News with Molly. Today we're going to be talking about a balanced diet. Now, balanced diets are very important because they basically make your diet balanced. So balanced diets include dairy, fruits and veg, protein, statutory foods and fats and sugar. In fact, I've even got a fruit in this bag. Let's take a look. It's an orange. An orange is a fruit and nice and healthy for a snack. Anyway, that's it for 5pm News with Molly. Catch you up with me tomorrow. Bye!
Oh, that was really great. 5 o'clock news with Molly. Probably another series there, I think, Molly. What do you think? All about the importance of a balanced diet. And I think that's probably particularly important at the moment during lockdown. I know I have to keep reminding myself to eat the right things. So well done to you. You did a lot of research too. It's great to see so many children putting in time and effort into their topic work. And it's great to see the use of technology too. Well done. Thanks, Miss Maitland and Mr. Price for sending over so that I could share with everybody. That's it for the good news boards. Let's see what next week, not next week, it's half term, the week after, what good news that may bring. Until then, take care. In actual fact, that's not it from me, is it? Southill's Got Talent. We've got a bumper edition for you this week. Here we go.
Watch me bleed until I can't breathe, shaking, falling onto my knees, and I'll be now without your kisses. I'll be needing stitches, tripping over myself, aching, begging you to come help, and I'll be now without your kisses. I'll be needing stitches.
And we all stick together like paper and glue. I'm Florence C, homeschooling is for me. Sometimes my mum gets all shouty and that upsets me. English and topic are fun for me, but maths gets my brain all fizzy. fingers crossed, it won't be long till we can all be as one.
We'll be right back.
Was there a hashtag there? There it is. Nice one. Thanks everyone for your help with that. Fab. Prior to that, didn't we have some great talent pieces this week? Singing, raps, that was part of year three and four's topic work, so well done to you. Guitar playing, dancing, football, basketball, and netball skills, bit of poetry. It was a bumper edition, wasn't it? Thank you everybody for being so brave and for sending your items in. We just love it. Keep them coming, usual address, you know what to do. And until next time, happy half term.
Happy Ted again here. Now it's time for Wellbeing Wednesdays, which this week is all about what's been happening in year five. They've been asked to think about connecting with others. And thinking back to the Christmas cards that they made earlier to elderly people in residential homes and what a difference it made to them. They were asked to write a handwritten letter to connect with somebody. It could be a friend or a relative or somebody they haven't seen for a while, telling them what they've been up to and reaching out to them to spread some joy during lockdown. I've had a look at lots of them that Year 5 have sent in, and I've been particularly impressed with letters that I've seen from Bodie, from Beau, from Jacob, from Macklin, from Fionn, from Bella and from Lucy. Well done you guys. Some of the things they're saying are really nice. Dear Grandma, I hope you are well and okay. We have had lots of fun going out. I hope I can see you soon, writes Jacob. Fionn writes to her friend, I really, really miss you. I wish you were here. What have you been up to? I have been drawing and doing my schoolwork to keep me busy. Well done, Fionn. Very important. We made some Rice Krispie cakes and it tasted great. I'll make you some soon and drop them round to your house. Brilliant stuff, Year 5. Well done.
Can't I do this? It should be so simple. It's not. Always remember to keep trying, because we all have challenges that we have to try and complete, and some of them may be really hard, and for different people, different things could be really simple or really hard. And we get that because we're all unique. And that's what makes us all special. So just remember, keep trying, and I know you will do it one day.
Hi everyone, we made our own I Can't Wait books. And it's full of things that we can't wait to do after lockdown is over. And here's mine. Finally, go to the park with all of my friends.
I can't wait to go to Centre Park with my family.
I can't wait to go to the swimming pool.
I can't wait to go to the shops.
I can't wait to go to my friend's house.
Oh well, this is easy. I can't wait, when this is all over, to go back to Malta for my big holidays.
Hi together with all my family and have a picnic and play games and enjoy being together.
Having parties when it is our birthday.
Be with my cousins.
I can't wait to go on holiday with my family.
I can't wait to go to the fun fair.
I can't wait to meet up with my cousins.
I can't wait to play a match with my friends.
Hello again, I'm back with my I Can't Wait To, and thank you for all your I Can't Wait To ideas. And today mine is go to a splash park. Bye!
Done, you guys. Thank you very much to everybody who gave us a 2% tip, and particularly thank you to Harmony for inspiring us to make a box of our own. And well done too to Izzy for her words of advice about never giving up. Right, and now is one of my favourite parts of the assembly. It's time for the Express Yourself videos you've sent in from home. Here we go.
Thank you.
Let's make staying at home exciting. Let's do some drawing and make a card. Making it interesting is not so hard, with lots of activities, exercise and run. Miss Curtis makes our homework fun. Stay at home, no more schools. Don't forget discipline, follow the rules. Back to the classes. We just can't wait. We'll miss going to bed and waking up late.
And that concludes Wellbeing Weekly. Well done, everyone. Next time, we're going to see the reception children and see what they've been up to. It's been great seeing you all keeping healthy and fit and looking after your bodies and your minds. Make sure you keep it up in half term. And now, it's time for the news.
Hold on, what's that? It's Mr. Mason. He's got himself out of the cupboard. I locked him in the cupboard and he's free.
That's right, I'm free. It's time for me to do the news. They had me locked in a cupboard. Right. I've got myself free. Here is the news. First up, the ultimate lockdown battle. This was the challenge we had with the Key Stage 2 children at school with all the children of the other schools in Weymouth and Portland, and I'm very pleased to tell you that we came second overall, which is a fabulous achievement. Our highest scoring class within school was Year 5, and our highest scoring pupil in the school was Zara, so well done everybody there. Zara actually scored 21,050 points, which I think everybody would agree is a fantastic score. It's half term next week, and of course no home learning will be set from us. I can hear the cheering from here. Chinese New Year tomorrow. There's a piece of news for you. It is the year of the ox. Pancake Day next week. Hope you're looking forward to flipping your pancakes in your kitchen. And we are back to school on the 22nd of February, or of course back to homeschool on the 22nd of February, when Google Classrooms will go live again. So we'll see you then. All that remains is for me to go and have a stern word with this hand puppet. And I think the well done penguin was involved as well. But I'd like to finish with a fabulous bottle flip, which I'm going to use this bottle of hand gel, because what could be more appropriate in these coronavirus times? So thank you very much for taking part in assembly, everybody who contributed. Have a great half term, and we look forward to seeing you back as soon as possible, and some of you on the 22nd. Okay, here we go. Bottle flip. It's going to be easy. Here we go. Oh, gosh. Chaos. Right. Have a great half term, everyone.